Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today I will be talking about pre-love luxury. I know you like that. I like it too. So I'm talking about Louis Vuitton pre-love bags. I love buying pre-love for a lot of reasons. But let's jump into it because I'm really excited and I have a lot of things to talk about. Pre-love, what is? There is a lot of different places where you can buy pre-love. There is online mostly, that's where I shop. Here in Montreal, there is one place, and this is not sponsored, but I know that they have a lot of pre-love items. If you're not comfortable going online to shop for pre-love and you actually like to see the items, I will recommend a place that is called La Friperie du Village. I think that's the name. I will tag their Instagram down below because they do have a lot of items like luxury, like Louis Vuitton, they have Chanel's, like Givenchy, anything. Like basically they have a lot of luxury pre-love and they're in beautiful condition and very good price. So that's a place like physically where you can go, but it's only here in Montreal. The other places you can go to shop for that is eBay. You can go also to therealrea.com, Tokyo Brand Off. I'm gonna try to link them all down below in the description box. All the ones that I know that are trusty, that you can trust. On eBay, for sure, there's a lot of sellers. You need to do your own research when buying on eBay for pre-love. You don't want to get on a fake. But mostly, what I do, like if I want to see if someone is legitimate on eBay for pre-love luxury, is to see the number of reviews, how many years they've been on eBay, and if they're actually like stored. There's a lot of stores based in Japan for pre-love and they're really amazing. They ship fast and they have a 100% guaranteed authenticity. So if you're not satisfied, they do offer a return. And why I will recommend buying pre-love. First thing is about the price. For sure you can get a very good deal buying pre-love. If the bag or the shoes or whatever that you want is too expensive, because if you buy brand new, they can be like thousands of dollars, and you would like to still have the item but like little bit of use, like not brand new, and you can sacrifice that part to have the item that you want, that's a perfect match. You can have a good price. For sure it's not gonna be like cheap, but it's gonna be a better price than the store. Second thing is reuse, like recycling. All the point is to someone's trash can be someone else's treasure. If I can buy something that for me is amazing and someone else doesn't want it anymore, it's better to go to me than going to the garbage or burn or anything. Sometimes you cannot even find them in stores. When you buy a purse that is really popular, like it just came out and it's sold out everywhere, sometimes you can find it there. Someone that bought it at the beginning and now they're just changed their mind or they want something else, they want to upgrade, I don't know, you can find them there. So there's a lot of opportunities. This is all I can tell you right now for that. If you have more questions, for sure I will be glad to be answering you. Moving on the bags. A lot of questions that I got about bags is what type of bag I would recommend to have as a first luxury bag. Depends on the brand, so there is not a right answer. Depends what you like, what brand are you planning to have, what is your budget. I will recommend if you go for a first purchase, no matter what is the brand, buy something that is classic. Neutral colors that is gonna match most of your outfit. If you go and buy for your first bag like a neon pink bag, because it's like really trendy right now, but maybe in a few months it will not be. And like, how can you wear every day a neon pink bag without getting like annoyed by that, because it's really on your face. This is my first bag that we'll talk about today, Louis Vuitton 25 Speedy. And this was my first bag that I bought from Louis Vuitton. So that's what I did. I followed my own advice when I bought my first bag. So this bag, like I showed you before, it is the Speedy 25. This is a classic from Louis Vuitton for decades, okay? It's been on the market, I think, since the 40s. Really nice bag, okay? I bought it. It is the old version because I'm having it for years. It's a perfect, still perfect condition because I really take care of it. But it is the version without the bandolier, monogram, print, basically matches everything. It's gonna upgrade every outfit I'm gonna put on. So basically I love the Louis Vuitton monogram. Like at the beginning when I fall in love with Louis Vuitton, I want a really Louis Vuitton monogram because like, was the point for me, like, I love the monogram. Now, more recently, I fell in love more with like plain purses, like not like the one the monogram, but I still love my classics. So this purse is a really good investment if you want to invest in a first purse. If you open it, you still have stuff, yes. It comes really basic with a pocket here, and it's just like plain. So you can fit a lot of things inside this purse. I really recommend it. So this is the 25 Speedy Louis Vuitton monogram. Moving on with my second purchase, it is this one I bought at pre-loved. It is a newer version of a Speedy. It is the 30, because it's, if you, as you can see, it's bigger, in the Damier Eben print. So this one I fall in love too because it is like a, it's like the parent of my 25 Speedy. It's a bigger version, I can fit more stuff, but really what I like more about this is like the ABN print. I really like it. Here it is not like the leather is not exposed, it's been paint already, treated. So I can go out, if it's raining or humid, I'm not scared that it's gonna damage the leather on the bag. So it's a more durable bag. If I open it, it's still not with the bandolier. Wrong, I did wrong. I should have invested like the little extra money to have the bandolier because like you can have it and it's more comfortable. But at that time I was like, I don't need it, but yes, I need it. I did. In this one, the lining inside is red and it comes in the same stuff, like you have a pocket right here and the rest is just like empty stuff. There's no divisions or anything, you can buy them separate on Amazon. And lastly and not less important is my third investment. It is the Never Fall Louis Vuitton with the monogram, logo monogram. And it, I think it's the PM size, it's not the bigger one because I'm a very petite girl, so imagine me with a big purse, I just can fit inside of it, like it's really big. This purse is like heaven on purse. I bought it pre-loved too. I got a very good deal on it. You can have this purse for years and it's gonna stay the same, like it's gonna remain the same and it can fit a lot. I will not even show what I have in here because it's mostly garbage. I don't know, I have a problem like keeping everything in my bag. So I will not show you what I have in the bag, but I can tell you that it fits a lot. I traveled with this bag and I put like 20 kilos inside. Okay, not 20, but 10 kilos. I will have put everything in here because yes, I will not pay for extra luggage. It is expensive, okay? So I would sacrifice and put it here. It's gonna tough. It's gonna tough whatever you put inside and it's gonna not break. I hope so. Okay? Till yet it has not failed me. So the only problem I got with this bag, and it's really annoying, is this straps right here. Like sometimes I'm just gonna grasp things and just leave and not even wash where I'm going. And every time I'm gonna put my purse, leave the house, and this thing is gonna get attached to like the handle on the door and it's gonna like, yes. So it had broken twice. Yes, twice. It had broken twice. So this thing is the only thing that annoys me. And like, what is the purpose of this is to shrink the bag. And I don't really like the shape when it's smaller, so it's just like decoration. Basically, it's just like decoration. And it caused me like a lot of problems. And the lining inside of this one is the beige one. It has a pocket in here with more garbage. And like the rest is like just empty thing. You can fit your whole body inside. That's it for today's luxury video. If you have more questions, remember you can always write them down below in the comment section. I will be glad to answer all your questions and concerns. I'm helping you guys acquire your first luxury if you're into that. Thank you very much to have watched my video. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video if you liked it. Or even if you didn't like it, you can even dislike it. I will take it. That's gonna be fine for me. But don't forget to subscribe. That's a very important part so you don't miss any of my future videos. Thank you very much, guys, and see you next time.